on. Show the wrist, bro.
Oh, I look like a stripper. Sexy? I don't know.
I already know what he's trying to do. You know what I mean?
I don't know.
Fuck.
どこ?
ここ。
ここ? さっき?
さっき? 5分前。
マジ?
こう、 俺を真っすぐ行ってる。 こうやって。
どんな自転車?
ポップで。
This one is here, and then make that one go on tighter and pull that one up.
And yeah.
Yeah. Stripper again. God damn. Real bondage action right here, dude. Real bondage action. Don't even want to play with me.
Do you think it should overlap or just one of the bottoms fine? Okay, it has been a minute since my last video. Finally had the chance to sit down and record again. As you can see, we are in a new place, but today I wanted to go over some outfits that I've been wearing. I guess these won't really be spring outfits, but more so outfits that I'll be wearing during the spring. I don't really wear loud patterns, prints, or vibrant colors. I tend to wear the same clothes and types of clothes year-round, keeping a pretty neutral palette. Again, mainly just want to use this channel as a way to keep track of my style journey in an authentic way, as well as some life memories. Hopefully there are some ideas or moments that you guys might find meaningful along the way. Some of these outfits feature some recent acquisitions here in Tokyo, and so my next video will most likely be a pretty hefty pickups video where I go into these items in more detail, so please stay tuned for that. So these first three fits might feel a bit repetitive. They're basically the same fit in three different fonts, and they feature some items I've showcased in my last two videos already. But as a chronic outfit repeater, I really just wear the same things pretty much every day. And obviously if I pick something up, I'm gonna try to wear it. The formula with these is really just some big ass outerwear, t-shirt, jeans, and black shoes. So for the first outfit, on top I have this vintage Lauren by Ralph Lauren wool shirt jacket. Underneath is a 100% wool t-shirt from H Beauty, a pair of vintage Levi's 517 denim, and Prada derbies. Although it's getting warmer during the day, it still gets pretty cold during the mornings and nights, and so I find myself wearing a lot of mid-weight outerwear still that is warm enough and protects against the wind. The wool t-shirt as well is really lightweight and soft, but also quite warm, and it just feels really luxurious compared to a traditional cotton or polyester t-shirt. With my second outfit, I basically just switch out the jacket for this military stand collar coat. I feel like cropped jackets and cropped hoodies have been trendy for a while now, which, don't get me wrong, I still enjoy and wear, but there's just something about throwing on some massive outerwear that I'm definitely enjoying at the moment. I think with these longer and more oversized outerwear, a pair of slimmer pants tends to work better in terms of achieving some more flattering proportions. And for this outfit, I'll sometimes switch out the Prada derbies for a pair of Kiko Harkman sneakers for a more casual kind of outdoor aesthetic, if you will. And the last fit in this set of outfits features something I honestly never thought I would ever wear, which is this vintage trench coat, also from Lauren by Ralph Lauren, in this really nice khaki taupe color. Very Sherlock Holmes-esque, but the color, shape, and fabric are all immaculate in my opinion. I really like how adjustable the jacket is as well. The inside lining, as well as the wrist straps, belt, and even the epaulets on the shoulders are all removable. And this is another recent pickup which I'll be going more in detail on in my next video. I think even though these first three outfits are pretty simple, follow a similar formula, and don't require much, if any, thought to put together. They all still look and feel pretty different stylistically, while also still somewhat cohesive. And I think inadvertently, these are some of my goals that I have for my wardrobe. All right, switching it up slightly, this next fit is a bit more on the grunge side, I guess. My Hot Topic edgelord phase is still going strong. I'm wearing a loose slash open knit sweater I recently picked up at a secondhand store, a pair of Professor E flare trousers, and the same Prada derbies. Since the sweater has a looser knit, the wind and air gets through pretty easily, so when it's a bit colder, I'll throw on something like this leather jacket. I actually wanted to go over these trousers a bit more in detail as well, since I wear them quite a bit. They have this side panel on both sides that is separated into smaller panels with these bar tacks, and so the shape of the pants slightly contracts and expands while you're moving. The inside features this floral pattern pocket lining, which, to be honest, is not really my cup of tea. It also has darts on the back waist, two back welt pockets, one of which has an extra flap of fabric, and the same floral lining. I think this style is one that I've naturally gravitated towards for quite a while, but at the same time recently I don't want to feel confined to in a way, but definitely an outfit I find myself wearing quite a bit still and enjoying the individual pieces within especially. Last fit is my 7-Eleven run outfit. Honestly, just a combination of the most comfortable pieces I have. Vintage oversized MA1 bomber jacket, a vintage t-shirt, which is single stitched and has this cracked cactus football print in a bright blue collegiate font. A pair of darted sweatpants from Bougidet, which are honestly my favorite sweatpants I've ever owned. And some Kiko Kostadinov Camper Lab shoes. A bit of a discount Raf Simons look, just something to throw on effortlessly that looks and feels.